when you look back on this year, was there a performance, a moment, a female empowerment moment that really stood out for you? I know a lot of people would say your work on Pose has been really tremendous. So when you think outside of your show, what would you say?
Outside of my show, I think it really is about the pushing together of this idea of building a coalition within the industry to ensure that we're all supporting one another and elevating one another's work, and to ensure that, you know, there is a greater kind of cohesion behind the scenes. It's great that we have folk in front of the camera, but seeing a lot of those folk then go behind the camera and use their power to kind of ignite a larger movement has been truly, truly inspiring to me.
And it's so great to see you here on a day that Nina Jacobson is being honored. What can you say about her, and what's different from her from other producers you've worked with?
Nina Jacobson is really like the blueprint for me. She is just, she leads with a quiet kind of confidence and leadership and authority. She's whip smart, super sharp, and she fights for stories that she believes should be seen. We're developing the feature for the adaptation of my book, Redefining Realness, my memoir, which I'm going to write and direct. And I'm working with Nina and Brad Simpson at Color Force. And so just to be able to work with them and to know them and to be lauded by them is just, it's so amazing.
It's amazing. Where do you go to get creative to write? Is there a spot in your house? Do you go somewhere else? Is it a trip you like to take?
I usually go to a little cafe around the corner from my house. I'm in West Hollywood. Or another place that I go is Hedgebrook, which is a women's writers retreat on Whidbey Island in Washington State. They support women writers. They create this space for them. And so I've written two of my books there.